I'm Robin Bennett. I'm district councillor in South Oxfordshire for the Green Party. Here at this is Wood Festival that we're at, which is my day job, organising Wood Festival. It's our year of the owl. So here's Michelle Barney Owl. And here we found an MEP candidate for the European elections. It's Ian.
Hi, I'm Ian Chandler. So I'm the Green Party candidate in Wales for the European elections. So fighting hard, but taking a couple of days off to come here to Wood Festival and really relax and be with some like-minded people.
So everything here, this whole festival is running on solar power. We can see some solar panels there. Pan around.
It's a really important part of just, you know, a festival like this, just being able to be close to nature, remind ourselves actually what it's all about, how close we are to the world that's around us. And we all need reminding of that occasionally, because it's such a precious thing that we live on this planet. And to be reminded about how interdependent we are with it is really important for us. And as we go into these elections, there is only one party that you can really campaign for, that you can vote for, that is going to guarantee to try and protect the climate, and that's the Green Party.
You can see there why Greens are different and why you do need Greens in the European Parliament. I mean, do you feel that there's a lot that the Green group can do in the European Parliament?
It is, because I think the Green Party is not just the Green Party of England and Wales, but we link up with all the other Green Parties around Europe. And of course, you know, with the different electoral systems, Green MEPs are really growing in Germany, in Scandinavian countries, in others. So we're actually a very powerful bloc in the European Parliament. And our MEPs, people like Molly Scott-Cato, has been leading the work in the European Parliament about tax dodging, ensuring that multinationals pay their fair share of tax.
I mean, it makes you think, I mean, we make such a big deal here about whether Farage gets votes or not, but you know, I think we know what his agenda, real agenda is, and it's a lot to do with the tax, I dare say.
It is, and you know, I mean, our MEPs turn up and they work. I mean, Farage is, you know, moans about Europe, moans about, you know, things like fisheries policy. He's on the fisheries committee in the European Parliament and he never turns up. He just takes the money and just moans and doesn't really work. You know, whereas we do the work, and I think that's what we've shown is that working together, we can really make a difference. We can create environmental standards, social standards that everybody has to adhere to. And of course, that's what people like Farage don't like. They don't like standards. They don't like a minimum standard. They want to be able to run roughshod over the ordinary people.
Golden time, you know, it's, well, it's mostly water.
But he plays that in a very populist way so that people don't realise what his real agenda is.